Imagine that a scientist told you that there are some people that lack a theory of mind. These are people who are apparently unable to understand that others can have beliefs, desires, and intentions different from their own. As a result, the scientist explains that these people lack empathy, are uninterested in other people, and don't have the ability to attribute mental states to themselves and others. They are labeled as autistic. As a result, people with autism are treated differently and are presumed to be incompetent in social situations, and perhaps even lack the desire to interact with other people. Naturally, you'd want to know the data on which such strong claims are made. In this presentation, we will provide evidence that challenges these claims and support the idea that people with autism do develop a theory of mind.
Traditionally, false belief tests have been used to test theory of mind. False belief is recognizing that people can understand the world differently from each other based on what they have seen or experienced. The classic test of false belief is the salient test. In a widely spread study, Samuel Baron Cohen and his colleagues used this test with both autistic and non-autistic children. In this study, autistic and non-autistic children watch an interaction between two dolls, Sally and Ann. Sally has a basket and Ann has a box. Sally puts the marble in the basket and leaves the room. Ann takes the marble from the basket and puts it into the box. Sally returns and looks for the marble. The subjects are then asked where Sally will look for the marble. To answer correctly on this test, children have to recognize that because Sally was outside of the room when Ann moved the marble, she will still think it's in the basket. In this original study by Baron Cohen, 85% of typically developing children answer correctly, while 80% of autistic children fail.
Although these findings have been replicated a number of times, it is important to point out that there are a number of shortcomings to the traditional Sally-Ann task, including it being motivationally barren. This could underestimate autistic individuals' theory of mind abilities. Additionally, most testing environments and apparatuses are laden with disadvantages towards people with autism, which scientists are now trying to eradicate. A simple change in the procedure to make it more motivationally rich resulted in dramatic improvement in autistic participants' performance. A study done by Peterson and colleagues changed the game by putting this false belief task into a competitive setting. In 2013's study, they began by setting up a real-life situation for the participants. Peterson and colleagues used a traditional Sally-Ann demonstration, but instead of hiding a marble, Sally hid a candy bar. After the demonstration with the dolls, the children were asked which doll should look for a candy bar first. If the doll didn't find the candy bar, the child got to keep it. This shows that the child must understand that the doll has a false belief about the location in order for them to answer correctly and be rewarded with the candy. 74% of children with autism passed this trial. Such a significant increase in the number of passing autistic participants shows that they were able to correctly attribute false beliefs to a doll.
Peterson and colleagues changed the framework of this test of theory of mind and found noticeably different results from Baron Cohen. Chevalier, another researcher, changed the environment of the testing situation and found better results for autistic participants as well. A study done by Chevalier tested the effects of having an experimenter in the room by having participants complete a theory of mind task in two conditions, differing in the way participants received information. In the social condition, a female instructor was in the room with the participant to give instructions and administer the test. In the non-social condition, participants were given instructions through a computer. Typically developing and autistic children were shown picture strips and asked to choose one of three pictures to correctly complete the story. The researchers found that while the typically developing group performed noticeably better in the social context, when the test was administered on a computer, the two groups performed similarly. The researchers suggest that typically developing children may be more socially motivated to perform and therefore benefit when an experimenter is in the room. So, changing the way in which we test for theory of mind can provide support that autistics do not lack it.
Theory of mind, of course, encompasses not just recognizing that other people have false beliefs, but also understanding that others have intentions that can be conveyed in various ways, for example, emotional expressions. If I smile upon receiving a gift, then the giver knows that I appreciate and am thankful for it. The classic Sally-Ann test ignores these other aspects of theory of mind. However, there is good evidence demonstrating that autistic children understand the intentions behind emotions. In a 2011 study, Vivanti and colleagues tested children with autism on their ability to gauge intention from facial expression. Participants watched a video in which an experimenter sorted pencils and pens. Participants had to determine whether they were sorting by type of utensil or whether or not they worked, based on the experimenter's facial expression. The participants then had to sort in the same way in which the experimenter in the video sorted. Autistics passed this task correctly, interpreting the experimenter's intention based on emotion.
This clear display of reading emotions is echoed in Life Animated, a book written by a father whose son is autistic. Ron Susskind writes about the effects of autism on his family's life. He, along with his wife and oldest son, described the family's life through stories and anecdotes about Owen and his connection to the world of Disney. The book is full of moments portraying Owen as an empathetic, intelligent, and social child. One of the most powerful moments was when the family celebrated Thanksgiving, and Owen, at a very young age, directed a play of James and the Giant Peach. Owen chose specific characters for each cousin and elaborated on why he chose to be the Earthworm, a character known to be shy and somewhat quirky. Owen states, "The Earthworm is scared sometimes and confused, and he's jealous of the grasshopper and the centipede and characters who can do things that he can't. And that's why I'm the Earthworm." Not only does this show Owen's understanding of emotion, both in himself and other characters, but it also demonstrates his ability to connect fiction to reality, which is a clear demonstration of theory of mind. First-person accounts like Owen's have helped frame the science surrounding theory of mind. As explained in this presentation, recent research in theory of mind in autistics has been moving in the right direction. Proper testing and consideration of first-person accounts can help ensure that we do not underestimate these individuals and their abilities.